If all you're looking to do is create an Excel chart, then see our online training for how to easily do that. You don't need a scorecard to do that. But if you want a well-designed system to organize your data and summarize it and archive it so that you can better analyze your hard-won data, that's what a scorecard is for. So on a daily or perhaps weekly basis, you're going to collect data from potentially multiple different data sources and put that data into this well-organized system to archive and analyze that data. And these are the subtopics that will teach you for how to do that. The first thing to learn is how to find your way around this template, because it has more sections than most. So like every Systems to Win template, it opens up to a help worksheet, and at the top there's the purpose, and like every Systems to Win template, there's help for any Systems to Win template, and just scroll down to find the instructions for how to use this specific template. And if we go to the sample sheet, we'll find that this template is just a little different than most. Usually there's the template itself in the upper left corner. But in this scorecard template, this upper left corner section of the worksheet contains instructions and tips for how to personalize the template. So if we scroll back, we see that there's an instruction to scroll down for your data and scroll right for the scorecard. But there's an even easier way to get around. In this upper left corner, we have this page navigation where you can just click one of these link icons to quickly take you to each section of the worksheet. And in each section of the worksheet, you will find a similar link icon that you can click to take you back to that upper left corner that contains the main page navigation, where you can click another link icon to take you to another section of the worksheet, which contains its own link icon, to quickly take you back to the main navigation in the upper left corner. So let's start by looking at the scorecard data section, which is where we will do our daily data collection, or perhaps weekly or some short time period. So let's scroll over and down to enter some sample data, starting with the date that the data was collected, and perhaps the shift. Now if you don't have shifts, you can just hide that column. Remember, you're in Excel. You can use everything that you know about Excel. So if you do have shifts, notice that this blue cell will concatenate the date and the shift, which will become important when you go to create your charts. Notice that it also automatically determines what day of the week that date was on, which can be kind of helpful too. So now let's start filling in some daily data. Problems might come from your check sheet. Accidents might come from safety reporting. Units produced and rejects might come from your production reporting. Your schedule and sales and operations plan might come from your production schedule. And if we scroll over, we'll find this section where you can add unlimited columns for user-defined purposes. And this section over on the far right that contains any formulas. Notice there's a whole bunch of pre-programmed formulas to make things easier on you. And you can add unlimited user-defined formulas using everything that you know about Excel. It's extremely important to keep all of your formulas on this far right section, because if you have any formulas on the left, they'll get wiped out by the period end processing that we'll see later. Now the source data for the problems section will usually come from a check sheet. Now the classic instructions for a check sheet are that it's intended to be printed, not used in a computer format, and people put their handwritten hash marks every time that a problem occurs. Now if someone happens to be a desk worker who finds it more time effective to enter their data into the check sheet form, then the Systems to Win check sheet is set up to automatically calculate those totals for you, which you can then copy. And then on the scorecard worksheet, select the Home tab, select that little arrow beneath the Paste, Paste Special. And because those formulas wouldn't make any sense in this other workbook, we want just the values. And because that was vertical data and this is horizontal, we click the Transpose checkbox and we click OK, and there you go. Now, if you already know how to use Excel, you already knew how to do that. But we're always surprised at how many holes there are in so many people's knowledge of Excel. And we're also surprised at how many of those same people believe that if they just buy some new software, they're going to somehow magically learn how to use that. So that's how you do daily or weekly processing. Now, on a less frequent basis, usually monthly, you're going to want to summarize and archive your data. So let's learn how to do that. When you click this period end processing button, it will copy the current period averages to the prior periods section and will clear all data from the current time period section. Now it's going to remind you that you should have archived your data in one of the three ways that we'll talk about in just a second, because you're about to wipe out your data. If you're ready, click OK. It did exactly what it said it was going to do. It copied your averages to your prior period section, and it wiped out all the data in your current time period. And it leaves your cursor in the title field for your next time period. So you can type that in now. And you're ready to type the date in the first row of the next period. And maybe the shift. And now you're ready to enter some data. And do it all again for another month, or whatever time period you're analyzing. Now there are three optional ways of archiving your data. The most popular is usually to save a copy of either the workbook or another worksheet before you go clicking that button. That way you've got your detail somewhere you can come back to later. Now in some situations, those summary averages are plenty of detail. You don't want all that detailed history. So then just click the button without saving anything first. And the third way is to scroll down to this history by date section, where you can store months of detailed history right there on the same worksheet. So just follow these instructions on the advanced training section of the help worksheet to teach you how to do that. Now, as soon as you save a copy of that template, that becomes your working document. You can do everything that you know about Excel to personalize that any way that you want. And then you can save another working document as a copy of that same template, and that one could be completely different. It's your working document. Now, the first things to personalize are in the scorecard data section. You'll want to personalize these orange headers in the problem section with your own problems and events that you want to track. And you want your title to reflect your work area or team name. And notice that the pop-up help is telling you that the text that you enter here also populates the same header field in the visual scorecard section. So let's use our page navigation to see if that's true. And yep, there it is. It's got the same title and the same author. You enter it once, it populates both places. And then scroll down to notice that the visual scorecard has some fields of its own that you can optionally personalize. Now notice that this uses a VLOOKUP to the table of translations and user substitutions, which is really useful if you happen to be personalizing the master template on behalf of your entire company. But you're not. Remember, we said this is your working document. You can use everything you know about Excel, including wiping out that VLOOKUP and replacing it with your own text. And you're not limited to just those few predefined user fields. You can put a field anywhere on this entire scorecard. Every cell in this visual scorecard is pre-formatted, so you can put your own fields and data wherever you need them without having to worry about formatting. And you're in Excel, so you can insert any kind of chart supported by Microsoft Excel, including bar charts, line chart trend analysis, area charts, pie charts, scatter plots, and using the popular and free data analysis tool pack, you can insert a histogram or all kinds of statistical charts. And if you need even more sophistication for statistical analysis from QI macros or Minitab, you can use those too. You're in Excel. You just have very well organized data now. And notice that your scorecard comes pre-programmed with some of the most popular charts you're most likely to want to use. Now remember, it's your scorecard. If you don't want these, you don't have to use these charts. You can drag it out of the print area or even press the delete key to delete it. It's your working document. But a lot of people are going to want a run chart, in this case showing the good units produced. And a lot of people are going to appreciate these three charts that show the prior period averages and the current period data all on one chart. Now, to see how did we do that, let's use our page navigation to go to the scorecard data section, where we notice that it is charting both these prior periods and this current time period all on one chart. Just a well-organized system for storing your data. And let's scroll over to notice another convenient feature. If we select this pink cell in the run chart column and type in the column letter for rejects rather than good units produced, then when we navigate back to the visual scorecard, we see that our run chart is now displaying rejects, not good units produced. Now, Pareto charts are much more difficult to program, so we've done them for you. We actually given you two charts here, so you always have a current period Pareto chart, which you can then compare to prior periods. And then if you select this drop-down list, you can switch between viewing the prior period's average or a specific month to compare to. And if comparing a specific month, you use the second drop-down list to choose which month. And if we scroll down, we'll find three very useful buttons. So the first thing to notice is that you can follow these link icons that will take you to online training to teach you how to use Systems to Win print buttons. For example, it tells you here that if you want to use print preview, you should use the Change Printer button to select the Microsoft XPS Document Writer instead. So we select the Change Printer button, select the Microsoft XPS Document Writer, and click OK. Double-click the XPS file wherever we saved it, and there you go. There's your print preview. Now notice that you can change the print orientation for this visual scorecard section separately from the data scorecard section. But if you're going to change it from portrait to landscape, you better be following our tips for how to personalize. Now the scorecard data section is set up to print landscape and uses Excel's regular print features. So for instance, you can select View, Page Break Preview, which then allows you to adjust your print area by simply dragging the blue borders with your mouse, which is something you're much more likely to want to do in this scorecard data section. And the final helpful button is the Copy Chart button. So again, you can click the link to go to online help, which will teach you that you can control click to select the entire chart. And by the way, you can select any chart, not just this Pareto chart, before you click the Copy Chart button, which copies a picture of your chart to the clipboard, where you can then simply paste it to any type of document. Maybe you want to paste a picture of your chart to your A3 report in Word, or maybe to your PowerPoint presentation, any type of document. And of course, you can use everything else that you know about Excel and Systems to Win templates to personalize your documents. That's why you purchased Systems to Win. You wanted a consistent, standardized way of really leveraging the standard features of Microsoft Excel.